For the past 2 weeks, I've posted my yearly award shows, one celebrating the best movies of 2022 and one celebrating the best TV shows of 2022. Now, if you're a normal person, you are probably too busy celebrating Christmas or New Year's Eve or some other holiday or festive event. I don't blame you, I would do the same. But believe it or not, there are more awards to give out. This is the Fun Film and TV Show Awards. Why is it fun? Well, it's focused on more entertaining awards, and you'll be glad to hear it has a lot less of me in it. I'm not sure if that's true or not, but it is fun to think about.
Have you known her?
What are you talking about?
Jordan, what are you doing?
I'm staying safe.
Really? Because it looks like you're grabbing a meat cleaver to go look for my boyfriend.
It's about giving yourself over to somebody, becoming one forever. That's love.
Get this. Dance,
you gonna try to blackmail me, sell the story? Let's not waste time here.
You don't know who you're messing with.
And I'm on the way up, and you on the way down.
Gunmen just tried to assassinate your father.
Stop it! Open the door!
Open the fucking door!
I'm trying!
Don't you know how to use your fucking car?
All we have to do is just think for a second.
No, we don't have to think. We have to drive.
Right, my door's fucking opening back up now. God damn it.
To run.
Genetic power has now been unleashed.
We made a terrible mistake.
The doomsday clock might be about out of time.
Action scenes can often add a bit of excitement to a movie or TV show. They get the adrenaline pumping, at least the good ones do. They require perfect timing, choreography, stunt work, acting, and a plethora of other bits and bobs. Whether it's a car chase, or a fight, or a race, or who am I kidding, they're mostly fights. The opening credits to a TV show are very important. They set the mood and the tone, they build hype, and they tell us who's in it and what it's called. Some TV shows don't have opening credits, shame on them. But it's their loss, because those shows aren't eligible for this award. TV shows are full of big, powerful, shocking, impactful moments. A great moment can surprise us, wow us, make us laugh, make us cry, or more. This award celebrates the moments that really stand out this year, the moments in TV that have us glued to the screens, figuratively speaking. If you're literally glued to the screen, something has went wrong and you may need a new TV. Like TV, movies have their big moments too, only bigger because those screens are huge. Trailers are awesome unless they're not. Some trailers show too much, others not enough. It's a craft, an art you could say. All designed to make you want to watch something. Maybe I should have had a trailer for this show. Or maybe that would have had the opposite effect. We all like good surprises. We all like seeing a name or face we haven't seen in a while or didn't expect to see. Unless it's that certain family member we all dislike. Don't know what I'm talking about? Guess what? You're that family member. Anyway, these next two awards are the best. cameos, a brief unexpected appearance from an actor we had no idea was in whatever it was we were watching. Heroes are key to most stories. They're the characters we support, the characters whose journey we get behind and follow. These next two awards are for the best heroes, not necessarily the heroes that win at the end of the day, although that does help. You're not much of a hero if you fail, I suppose. If a hero fails, I guess they're just nothing. Heroes are also a brand of chocolate collections, but they're not eligible here because caramel would win, hands down. Heroes need opponents. They need someone to contend with, to fight with, whether it's physically, verbally, or more metaphorically. Sometimes the villain of a movie or show is better than the hero. We all like a good villain after all, unless it's real life. We'll be right back. sadly, there's only so much time to be had in life. Also sadly, to get these shows written, shot and edited, I need a cut-off date. That means some shows and movies don't get a chance in my yearly award shows because they come out too late, or it could just be that I never bothered watching them. Either way, these next two awards offer films and TV shows that came out prior to 2022 that I only got around to this year.